Hello friend, welcome back to my channel KBS Technotalk. Today we are going to understand what are Azure Function. In this we are going to understand what is the Azure Function, key feature and benefits of Azure Function, use cases where we can use Azure Function, architecture and components of Azure Function, how to develop Azure Function, and what is the pricing model. In the end we are going to develop Azure Function and show the demo for that. So by definition, Azure Function is a serverless compute service that allows you to run event-driven code without having a explicitly provision for managed infrastructure. So what is the purpose of Azure Function? Simplify complex orchestration problem and accelerate the development. It will be more clear when we see the sample, and we'll see how we can deploy it and how we can run it using Azure Cloud. Okay, so some of the key benefits of Azure Functions are basically is auto scaling, scale up or scale down based on the demand. Event driven is a trigger by a variety of events, like let's say consider HTTP trigger, queue messaging, and it's a cost effective. What does it mean? That pay only for the compute resources what you are using. Multiple language support. Azure Function can be developed C#, JavaScript, Python, Java, and PowerShell. Okay, integration. It can be integrated easily with any other system and services. Okay, so what are the use cases where these Azure Functions are required? Sometimes you need a real-time data processing, right? That means you are having a large data which is required to process, and you want some kind of a listener to a particular source or stream data. In that case, we will use this. We can use this Azure Function. Automated workflow. Sometimes you have a file processing data transfer which need to keep listening or keep watching to a particular file location, and once the files drop that location, you want to process it. Microservice architecture. Breaking down monolithic applications sometimes is required. API and webhooks, binding serverless API and processing webhooks. Webhooks are basically a hooks which we can inject easily with Azure Function to run a particular jobs or to run a particular set of instruction which can be done by a Azure Function. Schedule task. Let's consider you want to have a jobs which runs frequently which you want to run frequently, then you can use Azure Function. Okay, so there are multiple way of triggering for Azure Functions, like HTTP trigger, TrimeS trigger, queues, like there are different binding, abstract and connection to external resources, input and output bindings are available. Execution context, the environment in which the function runs, and function up basically a container for one or more function enabling shared configuration and scaling. So a function app can have more than one functions. So for example, if you want to have one is file upload and one is file download, and you can create for both the purposes, you can create a single function app. Inside that, you can create two functions which you can use it. Okay, so to develop Azure Functions, we require Visual Studio or Visual Studio Code. Also, to deploy this, you need Azure Portal. Language, as we discussed earlier, language can be used C#, JavaScript, Python, Java, and PowerShell. In our demo, we are going to use C# and Visual Studio. Local deployment. Using Azure Function code tool, you can do the local testing. Okay, and deployment can be done using deployment tool like CI/CD pipeline or Azure Portal. Okay, so let's move to next section where we are going to discuss about the pricing model. So pricing model, one is called consumption plan. Pay only for the execution time of resources consumed. For example, if you want to run that function daily 1 hour, so it can be used for a particular consumption plan when you can pay only till the time what you are using that resources. Premium plan. The premium plan is basically a plan which provides advanced scaling, VNet integration, and more predictable pricing. Dedicated app service plan. It runs function within a app service plan for reserve capacity and predictable pricing. I will create another video to identify on which kind of scenario we should use which kind of plan. In the final, we are going to see a live demo and brief description about the demo scenarios. Okay, so let's jump on to the code. So in order to create a simple Azure functions, what I have done is I have logged in on the sandbox. How to log in on the Microsoft Learn Sandbox? I have created a video. The link for that particular video I have added into the description. So I have logged in on the Microsoft Learn Sandbox, and then I have switched the directory to Microsoft Learn Sandbox. Okay, then I will go to Visual Studio. I will open Visual Studio. Let me open the Visual Studio. I just open the Visual Studio, and then what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new project, and then I'm going to select a Azure function app. Here you can type it, Azure function app. Let's say Azure function. So I just selected it, and then I click on next. I have given that function app test. I need to give some unique name, so I just skip test, and then today's date is 20/06/2024. Okay, so this is what name I have given. So let's select it, and then I will put same name here, right? And then I will create next. Once I create next, it will take few seconds, and then it will create a Azure function. Here I have selected .NET 8 and then HTTP trigger just to demonstrate it. And then I am not enabling the Docker. I just selected the authorization leverage function. Okay, so let's do that function. Or we can make it anonymous as well. That's fine. So let's say function and then create it. Okay, so once I create it, I need to verify. Okay, so I need let me run it, and then I will explain what basically this function do that. So once I run it, I can see the build is happening. Once build successful happen, you will be able to see on console output window, it will be giving a it will give the a URL which we can use it for testing on browser. Okay, so first let's build it. Rebuild the solution, and then we will run it. That's fine. So we are running under .NET isolated. I will create a separate video for what is the function worker runtime if you give .NET or if you give .NET isolated. So we just build it. Now I will run it. Okay, so it's here. Now if I click here, it will open it on the browser, and we can see this working fine, because in our Azure function we have added this. Since it's HTTP trigger, it's behaving like an API. Okay, so I will discuss more detail on this. Let me go on the Azure portal, and then I will create a Azure function. Okay, so I will go here, and then I will go to home. I will create Azure function, right? and create a Azure function app basically. And I will select default one, this. I will select the default resource group, whatever is available. Function name, I can give any unique. It's not supported, this underscore. So we will remove that underscore from there, not a issue. And then runtime, I just selected the .NET because I'm developing in .NET. So I selected .NET and then I will click review and create. Right, so I need to enable the basic authentication. So what I will do here, I will go one by one and check monitoring and then deployment, and then I will enable that basic authentication. Okay, and then review and create. Now, what I will do, I will try to create this. So it will take few seconds and it will create the Azure function. Once the Azure function get created, I will try to deploy using Visual Studio. So in Visual Studio, I need to create a profile and then I will be able to deploy. To create a profile, first you should log in with the same user ID what you have used it to log in on the portal. So I have used same email ID which I have used on portal. So that's, we are good. And once it's created, basically it's a deployment is in progress. So let's wait for a few seconds. Till the time, we'll try to understand on the Azure function, what basically we have done. So whenever you create Azure function project, what does it do? It's create a program.cs file. In the program.cs file, all dependencies, whatever you have it, right? If you have any class which you want to register a dependency, you can add it also here. What are the services you want to, like here we are having application inside telemetry services, we want to log in, so that we can do that. Even though if you comment it, it will work, that's not a problem. Okay, and then host.run. So if you see the Azure function, how we do in .NET Core 6.0, you don't have this basically a program.cs file. And also in the host setting, you will be able to see most of the cases we use that function worker runtime .NET, not .NET isolation. This is a new feature, new way of deploying the Azure function being supported in .NET 8.0. Okay, then host.config is as usual. Host.config will have the all the settings, whatever is required. And then this is Azure function. So this Azure function, I have mentioned HTTP trigger. So since we are talking specific to HTTP trigger, we can we have defined this HTTP trigger type. And then this is the authorization label as a function. And then what kind of action verb is support is get and post, and then HTTP request. If you see in .NET Core 6.0, normally this logger information used to inject into the your action method, right, in run. But here it has a privilege to inject your dependency in this function class level, not in the function level. So that's how is in 8.0 is being recommended. Let's see on Azure portal. So I can verify here Azure function. If you go Azure function, and Azure function is created. Good. So what I'm going to do, that I'm going to select, and then I'm going to here, I will stop this application, and then I'm going to click on publish. Once you click on publish, it will, since the profile is not there, it will ask for curation. So I select this. I will select same Azure function app Windows. So I selected this, and then the same subscription, it will come from Microsoft Learn, directory, whatever I have. So I will click on finish. So it's basically create a profile, and also it will try to start publishing. So that's fine. You can ignore it. Let's say click on publishing. So it will publish it. So once it's published, we will be able to test our deployed Azure function, which we have deployed onto the Azure cloud. We will be able to test it. So the build and deployment is in progress. So you can see here output here. This all output is displaying here. This is very basic, simple, where we have not implemented any kind of authentication, authorization, and all. This is just very basic to just demonstrate that how we can create Azure function and deploy it on the Azure cloud without having a Azure subscription. So that's fine. Is publishing started now? Okay, so if you see here, publish completed, this is completed, and then it's trying to start that. Let's wait for a couple of more seconds. So now if I click on Azure Functions, right, you'll be able to see, and once deployed, deployment completed, right, whatever the user function name I've given, user function one, it will display here. So let's wait, function is ready, right? So if you see, whatever the function name I've given, so this get function URL, right? I will try to copy it. You can copy anything. This is our function URL, right? And then I will paste it here, right? I'll paste it, and we will see it's displaying the same response, whatever is displaying. So if you see here, it's displaying welcome to Azure function, because our function is having this. So right, welcome to Azure function tutorials. Let's say tutorials. I just make it, I saved it, and what I will do, I will publish it once again. Rebuild. Basically, when you click on publish, it will rebuild, but I'm just doing rebuild, and then I will publish it. Okay, build successfully happened, and then I will publish it. So let's click on publish. This is started publishing, and then you will see that after publish successfully happen, the message will get changed to this: welcome to Azure function tutorials, right? So let's go on publish. Here we will see the output. So publishing is going on. Yes, so build is almost completed, and then it will restart that function. Okay, function is ready. Now I will go to this and again refresh it. Okay, this is my Azure function, and then I will get function URL. You can test it from here as well. So I'm just copying in URL, copy it. And if I paste that URL here, right? Here. Right. So if you see here, welcome to Azure Function Tutorials. Whatever we change it, we are able to deploy it. I hope it helped you to understand the basic of Azure Function using .NET 8.0.